Welcome to this Azure Red Hat OpenShift video series. I am Roy from Microsoft and I work for the global Black Belt team as an application innovation specialist. And today I'm joined by my dear friend.
I'm Roberto Carratala, part of the Managed OpenShift Black Belt team working for Red Hat. And today's topic is who does what for updates and accessibility.
Okay, cool. So let's assume I'm a customer, I'm running a couple of Azure Red Hat OpenShift clusters, super happy, but something is going on with one of my clusters. What do I do then? What is the process? Could you double click on that?
Yes, absolutely. So Azure Red Hat OpenShift is a jointly engineered, supported, and operated by Red Hat and Microsoft. So I have the perfect diagram that will explain this. So let's discuss about it.
Perfect.
So imagine that the customer is facing challenges with the different Azure clusters. How they can have help? So the customer can open in both sides in the Red Hat portal and also in the Microsoft portal a support ticket. So in the background, the frontline engineers, so the support team from both Red Hat and Microsoft will start working to solve the different challenges. So if it's needed, they will work together and also they cross collaborate and cross hand over the different tickets in order to collaborate from Red Hat support frontline engineers and also from the Microsoft frontline engineers, having this cross-team collaboration in order to help the customer to solve the different challenges that they are facing. If the frontline engineers needs additional expertise, they can escalate to the SRE team from Arrow, jointly engineered and supported from Microsoft and Red Hat. So we have the SRE team from Microsoft and Red Hat taking care of solving these different customer challenges. Azure Red Hat OpenShift is like another Azure service. So it's following the exact same guidelines as the other Azure service is following as well.
Thank you. I think that diagram was really insightful.
My pleasure.
But you talked about an SRE. What is an SRE and what do they do?
So the SRE, or the Site Reliability Engineer, is a team that is looking proactively to installing, managing, and patching the different Azure Red Hat OpenShift clusters across the globe. So it's a jointly engineered and also a jointly support team around the different Microsoft and Red Hat team as well.
That's cool. And what are some of the things that they do for an Azure Red Hat OpenShift cluster?
For example, they looked and fixed different things around cluster networking. We'll also upgrade the different clusters to be up to date, apply the different security patches as well, any hotfix that appears of the security hotfix, for example. And also they are responsible to managing and fixing any trouble that, for example, appears in the cluster regarding the control plane or the different workers. And then the customer can focus in the applications with Azure Red Hat OpenShift clusters.
That's super cool. So basically a team consisting out of Red Hat employees,
correct,
Microsoft employees,
correct,
working together,
yes,
to make sure that the ARO clusters are up and running and doing their job for their,
correct,
customers.
Correct.
Very cool. Thank you.
OpenShift ships with a lot of different features. And also there is a cadence version, and there is also a life cycle of the different Arrow versions. So how I can upgrade the my cluster, and what are the different versions?
Sure. So let me first tell you that Azure Red Hat OpenShift works based on a default version, right? But I actually can hop over to the lightboard to explain it maybe a little bit better with a diagram as
Absolutely.
So as I just explained, Azure Red Hat OpenShift works on a default version. So for this example, I'm going to use version 4.11. So if I have my Azure Red Hat OpenShift cluster over here, version 4.11.x, what I can actually do now, when I deploy the Azure Red Hat OpenShift cluster, I can also deploy a 4.10 cluster. 4.10.x. But we don't stop there, because what I can do when I deploy the default version, I don't specify that I want to deploy another version, I can actually upgrade to, in this scenario, 4.12. The only thing that what we are saying is that you need to be on the stable channel when you are upgrading your cluster yourself. Now, upgrading a cluster could seem a little bit tricky, right? Maybe some risk to that. But actually what OpenShift did, they made it very easy for you to do an in-place upgrade. You basically log in, you say, I want to have this version, this is the upgrade pad, press the button, sit back and watch the show. So now OpenShift will start updating all the different operators and the nodes, right? And the cool thing is, if something goes wrong, OpenShift comes with built-in rollback capabilities so that we still can give you a functioning platform and a functioning cluster and modify it as you see fit. So this is how it works with upgrading and what we do support and don't support. In the end of the day, if you think about it, it's N minus 2 from a supportability perspective. And feel free to upgrade to the latest, greatest version as long as you stay on that stable channel.
Thank you very much, Roy. It was very, very insightful. Sure. So around the access and also the role-based access control that you can have in the different Azure clusters, how this is working?
Sure. So I think there are two parts to this question. And first thing first, we have Azure Active Directory.
Yeah.
And with Azure Active Directory, you can actually connect this to your Azure Red Hat OpenShift cluster. Mm-hmm. So people can use their Active Directory credentials to log in into the cluster. Now, obviously, Azure Active Directory comes with a lot of cool security features and also identity and access management solutions, RBAC, et cetera, right? So that's the first part. That's hooking in identity provider to your Azure Red Hat OpenShift cluster. Right. Well, the second part is obviously leveraging the RBAC capability that OpenShift puts on the table. So we can do group sync, for example, and we can specify all kinds of role-based access controls inside of the OpenShift cluster, making sure that the developer can access, for example, only the developer portal in a specific project. Maybe the administrator of the cluster can do a little bit more and can trigger an upgrade or do a additional machine set build, right? All those capabilities are built in, and we can do that with the RBAC capabilities of OpenShift and in combination with Azure Active Directory as well.
Brilliant. And you can control the fine-grained role-based access control, giving the proper permissions and the proper roles to the different developers and the ops teams as well.
Yeah, 100%.
Brilliant. Thanks.
Sure. So, Roberto, we talked about what the SRE team does and who's responsible and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But obviously, there are also customers in play, and they do custom things to the cluster based on their workloads. So how would you explain in your words how that responsibility looks like?
All right. So Azure ships with a default configuration and also with a default operators that are managing the different pieces within Azure clusters. So the customer is responsible for their own applications, workloads, and also data that are storing on top of Azure clusters. So imagine that one customer is deploying one workload and will be responsible for this specific workload and also the data that is deployed within the different Azure clusters. And also imagine that this customer wants to deploy also a third party, will be also responsible for that. So essentially, the Azure SRE team will look after the different operators and the default configuration, and the customer is responsible for the workloads and the different data that are deploying from on top of the different Azure clusters.
Okay, cool. So the way I'm hearing that, everything a customer does specifically based on their needs and requirements, they also carry a responsibility in the lifecycle management, the backup if they need that, and things. Okay, cool. That's very insightful.
Yeah, and sometimes it's a little bit tricky to understand that. So check also the description in order to go to the official supportability matrix and learn more around the different supportability features and the customer responsibilities as well.
Awesome, thank you so much. And if you want to learn more about Azure Red Hat OpenShift, we actually created a couple of really awesome videos, so go check them out. Another thing that you can do is reach out to Microsoft or Red Hat to help you and support you along the way. Thank you.
Thanks.